Robert Welch brand is contemporary classic design. So we design things that we want to last for years.
My father started the business back in 1955 and set up here in Chipping Campden in the top floor of this old silk mill. And the second generation carries on in the same ethos as my father did all those years ago. My name is Rupert Welch and I'm the managing director of Rob Welch Designs in the UK. 10 years ago, we bought our first 3D printer, and I have to say, unquestionably, I think it's one of the best things we ever did.
Within Robert Welch, we have a huge range of products from housewares, bathroom, to livingware. The materials that we use here are predominantly stainless steel, but we like to have a little twist.
What we aim for, I guess, when we're designing is designing very simplistic but classic, timeless pieces.
Being able to print things here, it really speeds the process up. It's actually like having another employee, really.
In the past, I've run 50 to 100 different spoons, changing the shape a little bit, adding an angle, and it changes the pattern completely.
From quite an early stage, the 3D printers are involved.
We'll go through lots of different iterations and we'll discuss it with the team, and then we'll start printing.
Using the MakerBot allows us to really get the shape refined and make sure that it feels nice in the hand. You can actually use it. It's a 3D object, so people can understand it.
And there's no real sort of risk, you know, if we think, actually, should we just print a model just to be sure, rather than sort of worrying about the cost of it. So we can just print as many as we want. And then as it gets closer to finalising the design, we'll go and move it onto the Object 30.
Using both MakerBot and then an Object 30, they're both transferable between what we're looking to print. If we're looking for something of a higher resolution or a detail.
It's absolutely fantastic for cutlery. The output is incredible. The resolution is so tight and so high. It can handle the thickness of the bowls, which are 1.2 millimetres thick. It's also the strength of it as well. And it's been an absolute godsend because there's no mess, there's no fuss with it. It just prints.
And then you get a really precise, really crisp model, which allows you to get all the correct thicknesses that would be in steel.
And then we can send out models to the factory. We'll send them the CAD, we'll send them the drawings, so they can see in three dimensions what we're trying to get. They'll make slight adjustments, send the CAD back, we'll then print another version.
If we can print what they're thinking and the changes they've made, that's perfect for us. We can run them overnight when we've gone home, come back in the morning, and they're ready for us to then reevaluate, you know, refine again if we need to. So our 3D printers are very much part of the team. We can't invest until we know everything is right. So this allows us to cut out mistakes.
It was a fantastic business decision. All the things we could challenge, we could question, we could take the whole process on a journey, and eventually we come up with what we think's right. And that's what's so exciting about 3D printing, is the ability to question, to challenge, and to push the boundaries.